Hi, Sion.
Hi, Sebastian. How are you?
Fine, thanks.
Yeah, great. I thought we'd give you a call. And we wanted to know if you could come over tomorrow. Tom, the head of closures, and myself will be looking at the closures and exterior parts and thought it'd be a great opportunity for you to join us. How's your availability?
Yeah, sounds good. I can be there anytime tomorrow. And many people in the community are already waiting for it. So great topic.
Yeah, great. Then we'll see you tomorrow and we can show some of the parts and the team and go through all the bits that we've got.
Yeah, happy to see you. Thanks for calling.
Great.
See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Hi. Today is about body closure, everything outside of the vehicle here. And for this, I'm very happy to have an expert with me, Tom. Tom, great to see you.
Hi. Nice to see you, Sebastian.
So what do you do at Sono?
So my name's Thomas Price. I'm the head of body closures at Sono. And what means body closures? It means everything that opens on the car. So all the structural parts, all of the ceiling, all of the mechanical parts that we can see in the charge lid, eventually the hood on this car, the side doors, and the tailgate on the vehicle as well.
I've seen that you've covered the charging lid, which is a pity because many people want to see it. But is there anything else you want to show us?
Yeah, sure. So we could take a walk to the side and I can show you some of the systems in the side doors on the second car that we've built. So here you can see the front and the rear side door on the car, completely finished, assembled to the vehicle as they would be in the final stages of the series production. And we have all the functioning mechanisms, the solar body panels and the window regulators assembled in here as well. And actually now the door is open, you can see the complete assembly together. So we have the mechanism for lifting the windows, the inside and outside handle access system is visible. And you can also see here the electrical connection from the solar body panel is already made in the completed assembly.
Yeah, it's nice to see. This is really nice.
So perhaps I can show you a little bit more of the sub-assembly when we go to our sub-assembly area. Mm-hmm. And you can see how all the components are coming together to create the finalized product that we put to the vehicle.
Yeah, let's do this. So where are we now?
Okay, so Sebastian, thanks for coming with me. We're in the area of the closures and exterior sub-assembly. So around us, we can see all of the fixtures that are required to build the door, tailgate, hood, and all the exterior part sub-assembly. And in front of us here, we can see a number of parts that you previously saw completely built on the vehicle. So we'll first start by having a look at one of the door sub-assemblies in a nearly completed state. Then we can have a look at the hood assembly, which is almost complete. And then we see the beginnings of the process in our prototype fixture, which is the tailgate. So yeah, we'll take a walk around, see the different processes, the different technologies we have in our parts, and then gain a complete understanding how the assemblies come together for the complete vehicle.
Yeah, sounds good, thanks.
So let's start by having a look at the door assembly. So here you can see a front right-hand door, and basically exposed without the solar panel is all of the mechanisms and all of the parts in the door assembly. So we can see polymer parts, metallic parts, and everything that is inside a door assembly.
And this is for the solar panels, like to clip them in?
Exactly. So the last step for us, and it's the only step remaining for this door, is to fit the solar panel on the outside with these clipping positions. And then we will do the electrical connections from the other side with the wiring harness that provides the solar power to the rest of the car.
So when people want to exchange the solar panel or when there's a repair, you disconnect from the inside and then you can like pop it out.
Exactly. So it's designed so that the clips are easily removable. We have four bolted connections which are easily accessible when the door is open. And then, yeah, basically removal and replacement of the solar body panel is designed to be as efficient and quick as possible while maintaining a structural rigidity to the parts.
So when we now talk about solar panels, we have a complete video on this up in the links.
Okay, so let's take a next step into the hood assembly. This is obviously fitted to the front of the car, and what we can see here is a nearly complete hood assembly. So the solar panel, the structural inner panel, and all of the mechanisms and the electrical connections for the solar panel as well.
And here you can also see like the honeycomb structure. This is for stability, right?
Exactly. So the way we have a PV label on the outside needs some support on the rear side to ensure no vibration or a structural stiffness to the hood to make sure that the part is reliable or the assembly is reliable for the rest of the vehicle life.
Understood. And this is for gluing. Is there anything that comes on top or why is Why is that?
So you can see right next to you a couple of clamps. So we use these in the gluing process. And what these do is keep the steel inner panel compressed to the solar body panel and ensure a good compression of the adhesive in the sub-assembly manufacturing process. So there's no peeling away of the inner panel from the solar panel, and we have a good strong assembly at the end.
Super interesting.
Okay, so now we take a walk over to the first part of the assembly process. And this is really the beginning of the construction of one of the closure's parts. So this is the tailgate, as we can see, the aperture for the rear screen, and then eventually the solar body panel will be applied here. And this is really the beginning of the process. So the first part is placed to the prototype fixture, the primer, and then the adhesive will be applied. And we also put the first step of the wiring harness in here as well. And then in the end comes the spoiler, the glass, and as you can see from the assembly instructions, the solar panel will be fitted in the last stage of the tailgate construction.
Mm-hmm. And so the rear view camera, where does it go?
So the rear view camera will eventually be fitted directly to the solar panel, somewhere around here. And that is sub-assembled after the solar body panel is glued to the tailgate.
Yeah, thank you. That was super interesting. Thanks for showing this to us.
Oh, you're welcome. Anytime. Should we take a short walk and meet Simon for the exterior parts?
Sounds good. Oh, by the way, there's also already a glass fitted here. So this is how it looks like when it's completed.
Exactly. So this is a finished assembly. And this is one of the tailgates that we'll use for testing on the system level. So we'll take the sub-assembly, put it to a fixture, and this is where we do all of our strength and stiffness testing, and also some kind of misuse and abuse case testing on the complete assembly as well.
You did some testing already, I think, telling from the looks. Okay. Yeah.
So with this particular tailgate assembly, we won't be doing any corrosion testing. This is why the solar panel doesn't have any additional coating on top to prevent from corrosion happening. So that's why it looks a little bit unfinished.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, thanks. Hi, Simon.
Hi, Sebastian.
Nice to see you.
So first question, what do you do at Sono?
So I'm responsible for the exterior of the car, so I'm head of exteriors at Sono Motors. Well, so everything we can see, the exterior of the car, that belongs to us. All the fixed panels, lights, bumpers, and everything you'd actually see from the outside. We're also responsible for the complete appearance of the car as well.
Mm. Okay, so also like the solar panels on
the integration on of the solar panels into the vehicle, yes.
Okay, and can you help me a little bit on the difference of body closures and exterior? Where's the difference?
The main difference is if it opens and closes, then it's closures. If it's fixed and doesn't move, it's the exterior. So, as I said, the fixed panels you can see down here on the sides and the bumpers, these would all be under me, under the exteriors. But the lift gate, the doors and the hood panel, they're closures, they open and close.
So what are you currently working on?
So currently the team and I are working on fitting all the parts that have come off the tools, making sure everything's now fitting exactly the way we've designed it, making sure there's no errors, making sure all the design fits. We're looking at gaps, flush, fit and finish, making sure that everything actually goes onto the vehicle the way we actually intended it to.
Okay, and is there anything like a special challenges building a solar car?
There are many challenges to building a solar car. Your conventional vehicle would generally be made of a stamped body in white. So this would be completely stamped out of aluminium or steel. So all these panels you can see would be metal. They'd be painted in the color of your choice or the choice the OEMs suggest for you. But for us, we have a completely polymer exterior. So that means the roof is polymer with the solar panels integrated. We've got the big ones on the side, in the doors, and on the fenders. And then we've got all the cladding and trim panels there also covering up the unique space frame that we have underneath. So very different from a normal car. There are some similarities. You'll see the bumpers, for example, wipers and glass. That's what you'd get on every car. But if you start to look a bit closer, you'll start to find that there's a lot more plastic and a lot more trim parts on these cars than you would normally have.
So, are you satisfied with the current result? Because the vehicle is getting closer to being ready.
We're really actually pleased with the vehicle as it's come out now. I can show you some of the bits around that we're actually most proud of, especially in this rear corner. Obviously, you can see the lights, a complete upgrade from what we had on SVC2. The bumper as well, although it looks very similar from a rear end, it's got some nice new design features. The fit and finish here is much more improved, and the glazing is improved as well. So the sleek design down the side is much more improved. We've upgraded some of the parts. Now are already off series tool. So some of the parts in the under trays and that, we went straight to series tooling. They're already installed, and we can have a look at some of the detail if we get down there. But as an overall, we're actually really impressed with the parts we've actually received at the moment. We do have a few teething problems, which we'd expect to find at this point. Some of the solar panels, they do have a bit of waviness to them. That's just natural at this stage. You'll see the roof is really nice. We've managed to get those to a standard we are happy with. But just in the normal automotive process of developing these large components, you can see the size of this side panel is quite complex. And of course, we've got some work to do to improve on that. But it's still what we class as really happy. The fit and finish is going well. You'll see there are some challenges still to do with the doors fitting to the rest of the components. Not everything goes together the way we would have hoped. But at this stage, and for the level we're at, I'm super impressed with the parts that we've got and where we are.
Yeah, it really looks good. It's really at a stage where we'd say, yeah, we'll take it.
So we had some challenge up here. Where you can see some of the misalignments, but this is absolutely normal in this stage of production. Most OEMs would never show you these. So what actually everyone's seeing today is something that is unique to us at Sono, and you wouldn't actually normally get as close as you are now and see some of these defects that you actually can see here today. So overall, it's quite impressive for what we've got.
I have one more question. You have a mix of materials. You have metal and you have black plastics. And is there anything you have to take into account because they move differently in heat?
Yeah, definitely. For the thermal expansion, whether it's hot or it's cold, we've got to be very careful with the material choices that we pick for the plastics. So you'll see up here and these parts, this is all plastic. When they get hot, when they get cold, they shrink or they increase in size. And so we have to be very careful they're not rubbing against each other, not causing any squeak or rattles. So we choose the right materials that work together with each other. But also you'll see there's some much larger gaps that you would probably get on a normal car. That's just to make sure that the thermal expansion is taken care of and that we don't get any issues of parts actually losing their shape or actually interfering with each other. In some areas, we've managed to close those gaps with the good location strategies, but in other areas, we know that we will get some movement, and therefore we need to mitigate that with some bigger gaps on the car.
Yeah, great. So thanks for your time.
Thank you.
Thanks for all the explanations.
You're welcome.
And keep up the good work.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you. Yeah, that was the update on body closures and exterior. I hope you liked it. We've seen a little bit more of the car. But that's all we have for today. If you're interested in more of these videos, we have a long list of content up there where you can go through. Thanks for watching and stay safe.